Hi, I'm Jose Berumen, one of the founders of the Hispanic Contractors of Colorado and also a past president. When HCC was launched in 1990, I was the owner of Laser Electric. I am honored to see the continued success of the HCC and the impact it continues to make across the industry here in Denver.
Hi, I'm Lene Cook with LEI Companies, and Jose is my dad.
My parents were founders of HCC, so speaking of impacts, this association has been part of my life for 25 years. So when my brother and I launched our own company in 2001, we knew the benefits of HCC membership and the power of advocacy. I served as HCC president in 2004 and 2005.
The timing of the founders was perfect. In 1990, Denver adopted an ordinance that established participation goals for minority and women-owned businesses on certain city construction and professional design projects. It was dubbed the MBE-WBE ordinance, and it was soon challenged in the courts, thus suspending the program.
I remember this moment in Denver history as I was just starting high school and was watching my parents face challenges as business owners. While I didn't fully grasp the impact, I was witnessing the effect. In June 1992, HCC was approached by the City and County of Denver to join in a pending lawsuit by Colorado Concrete Works against the city. The lawsuit challenged the constitutionality of the MWB ordinance. Before agreeing to join in the lawsuit, the HCC, having long-standing liaison committee with the Associated General Contractors, scheduled a meeting with every identifiable group representing gender, race, or ethnic-based construction firms. All groups agreed to refrain from becoming involved. However, they decided to form a coalition, which became the Colorado Construction Industry Coalition, known as CBIC. CBIC hired a professional facilitator to examine the entire question of underutilization of minority and women-owned construction firms. Its goals were to develop programs to educate MWBE firms in the construction industry, develop programs and systems that would promote utilization of minority and women-owned firms in private construction projects not covered by any legal mandate addressing underutilization, and undertake a review of the Denver MWBE ordinance.
In February of 1994, CBIC, chaired by Ron Norby with Hensel Phelps Construction Company, undertook a complete review of Denver's MWBE ordinance. Because CBIC was so diverse and included key industry leaders, Mayor Wellington Webb recognized the coalition as an appropriate body to make recommendations. The group met almost weekly for several months, and a representative from the Mayor's Office of Contract Compliance was always in attendance. The result was a list of general recommendations presented to Mayor Webb at the end of 1994.
Legal challenges continued for years, but the entire experience resulted in HCC establishing a solid, positive relationship with the majority contracting community, which has continued for 25 years.
I am proud to say my dad was one of the champions of this effort, and HCC continues to strive for the same opportunities the founders so passionately advocated for.
My professional involvement in the association began just over 10 years ago. A key focus for me has been involvement in the City and County of Denver's MWBE program, because I couldn't let the program that my dad had fought so hard for die without a fight. The apple doesn't fall far from the tree. In 2003, the U.S. Supreme Court declined to disturb the 10th Circuit's decision in favor of the city in Concrete Works versus Denver. Therefore, the MOCC's program was constitutional. This decision coincided with the election of John Hickenlooper as Denver mayor. He convened a task force to undertake a disparity study and develop a new MWBE program if the study supported it. I and several other HCC members and staff participated from the very first meeting in 2004, and many of us have been involved ever since. The disparity study indicated that a program was still needed, so Denver reestablished it through the Construction Empowerment Initiative, known as CEI, in January 2007. In addition to MWBE, the CEI also established a small business component called the Defined Selection Pool, a very innovative program. The only Denver-certified SBEs can bid on projects in the pool. Thus, they have an opportunity to be prime contractors. I had the opportunity to co-chair the CEI committee for several years. During the time, we conducted the second disparity study and restructured the MWBE SBE program that was launched in April 2014. There was enough growth in MWB companies that the new program was higher with aspirational goals and increased the size standards for MWBE construction companies. These programs have been invaluable to the growth of my company and many others. From 2008 through 2013, the city and DIA have awarded over $400 million to diverse businesses. Advocacy for these programs has been worth every minute of my time, and they've contributed to the growth of HCC members and other diverse businesses for 25 years.
Lene and I would like to thank all of the Hispanic contractors members who have supported HCC in its fight for diversity, and we thank all of you for spending your evening celebrating the many successes of HCC. Thank you.